dear participants and moving ahead, and now for this session, Professor Manish Sachdeva from Department of Industrial Production Engineering and IIT Jalandhar will be giving this talk on MCDM approaches. Sir is eminent academician and administrator, and he is doctorate from IIT Roorkee in the domain of industrial production engineering. Solid with the experience of more than 30 years of teaching and research, Sir has guided numerous PhD and almost 200 plus count of the research articles in this domain, and his research areas are also in this area. And we welcome you, Sir.
Thank you.
Currently, Sir is Dean Student Welfare. Prior to this, he was Dean Academic in this institute. We welcome you, Sir. First of all,
being coordinator, I need no introduction basically, but thank you again. Thank you, Sathya, for the nice introduction. Actually, I have a meeting at 12:45, so I will quickly go through the slides, so not take much of your time. The topic of a talk is MCDM approaches, multi-criteria decision-making approaches. So many of you might be working on this area, but there are many who have not gone through these techniques. These are general techniques and can be applied in any sphere of life apart from the research. So you can use it in daily life, you can use it in research, you can use it in other application areas. So wherever you feel, you can use these techniques. am I audible without this?
Yes, sir.
Jelney in his book on multi-criteria decision making open with the statement, in 1982, it has become more and more difficult to see the world around us in a unidimensional way and to use only a single criteria when judging what we see. So basically, what does this mean? We have to make the decision on basis of multi-criteria. Now if you go want to buy a car today, what happens? You will look for the cost, you will look for the mileage, you will look for the aesthetic, you will look for the safety features, you will look for the ergonomic aspect, you will look for many features in that. So it's not only the cost that will matter when you buy or go for buying a car. You look for many features, many criteria on the basis of which you make the decision. So This becomes possible only if you have multiple options for the same product. If you go 40-50 years back, there was hardly any choice. Either it was Ambassador or Fiat. There was hardly any competition. Then there was no fun of having the multi-category decision-making approach. So it was only the pick and choose, only the one or two option available, and you have to choose among them. But today, what happens? You have multiple options, and when the multiple options are there, you have multiple criteria also on the basis of which you make the decision. Similarly, there are other examples. This is the example of locating a nuclear power plant. This involves various criteria on the basis of which the location is decided. That can be safety, health, environment, cost. Then, an electrical route for the power transmission in a city, there can be the various objectives like cost, health, reliability, importance of the area on the basis of the decision, on the basis of which the decision has to be made. This is a problem which is faced by everybody once in a life at least. So, spouse selection problem, you look for religion, beauty, wealth, family status, family relationship, education. Of course, these are not the exhaustive criteria. These are some of the criteria. There can be many more. So, there are other application areas, resource allocation, hiring, evaluating and promoting employees, PQM, strategic planning, relocation decisions, vendor selection, evaluating mergers and acquisitions. There you need to make multi-criteria decision making. So what are the steps involved in MCDM approach? What are the typical steps involved in MCDM approach, in any MCDM approach? These are decision makers. Who is going to be the decision maker? For example, I have said that you have to make a decision for the car selection. Now, in the car selection, there can be many segments, whether it's going to be a 5 lakh car or 10 lakh car or 20 lakh car, because the priorities will keep on changing. If you go for a 5 lakh car, what happens? The predominant criteria in that case will be the cost. But if you go for a 20 lakh car or 25 lakh car, what will be the predominant criteria?
Safety.
Or aesthetic, comfort. Cost will become irrelevant. So you have to see who is the decision maker. For whom you are going to make the decision. This has to be looked into. Then the next step comes identifying the alternatives. What are the options available for that product? So as I have already told you, this becomes relevant, these techniques become relevant only if you have multiple options available with you. Make sense. If there are no options available, then this does not make sense. Then comes identifying attributes and criteria. So that can you find through surveys, expert opinions, nominal group techniques. So these are some of the methods which can be used to find the criteria which you are going to use in decision making. Then comes the attribute criteria weighing. So we have to weigh each criteria that has been selected, that has to be identified. Because as I have already told you, that if it is a 5 lakh car, the cost will get way more weight. If it is a 25 lakh car, the safety or the comfort will get more weight, right? Then evaluating the alternatives and selecting the best one. So I will try to cover these techniques, AHP, ANP, TOPSIS, Promethe. If the time permits, I will discuss Promethe also. There are many techniques, such techniques, Electre, Viker, there are number of techniques, but we will be discussing some of the techniques. So the first is analytical hierarchical processes. The analytical hierarchical process is a procedure designed to quantify managerial judgments of the relative importance of each of the several conflicting criteria used in the decision making process. Basically, what we do in case of EHP, we make the pair-wise comparisons. By taking pair, we make the pair-wise comparisons. So how we do that, that we will discuss with the help of an example. So it is basically a quantitative method for ranking decision alternatives and selecting the one with the help of given multiple criteria. There is a process of developing a numerical score to rank each decision alternative based on how well each alternative meets the decision maker's criteria. The question, which one do we choose and which one is the best, is answered by this technique. It involves simple mathematics. There is not much mathematics involved in. You can find ASP calculators on the net and which can be used in the Excel. Then criteria is again set by the decision maker. Preference of the criteria is also set by the decision maker. Preference means weights to the criteria. That is also set by the decision maker. Then there are standard preference tables. So this is the standard preference table which we use. If two criteria are equally preferred, then we give a weight of 1. If equally to moderately preferred, 2. Moderately preferred, 3. Likewise, we give the weights. This is the standard table which was given by the SETI, who designed EHP in 1980. So this is the standard table which is used. Now this is the example. Now let us suppose we have two products, A and B. The cost for A is 60 and cost for B is 15. And the quality is above average for A and quality is right at average for B. Now, when you compare, first we have to, here there will be two matrices. One is for cost, another is for quality. So when you go for cost, we have two products, A and B. So which one will you prefer? Naturally, A or B?
B, sir.
B. You will prefer B?
Yes.
So how, by how much? Then we have to see this game. How much do you have to prefer? Strongly to very strongly or very strongly, naturally very strongly? In that case, it will be very strongly or very strongly to extremely prefer. It is your choice. Some will say very strongly, some will say extremely, but this will vary from person to person, from decision maker to decision maker. So once you have decided this is that this is very strongly preferred to price of A, we have to make a matrix like this. B over A 7 and the B A over B will become reciprocal. And diagonal matrix will be 1 by 1, 1. Similarly, for the cost. Cost one is at above average, another is at right at average. So, which one will you prefer?
Yeah.
Above average?
Yes.
So, above average, another is right at average. Lekin jyada difference nahi hai dono mein, there is not much difference. So, what will you do? You will say it is moderately preferred. A over B is moderately preferred by a score of 3. So, reciprocal will become 1 by 3. So likewise, we have to make the matrices. So this is the technique. I am skipping that step. I am going directly going to the example. What are the steps from the example? Another example I will see. Okay, you see this example. This is how AHP is defined. First, you have to make a hierarchy like this. Selecting a new car, hierarchy is made. The first, we have to write the objective. What is our objective? In the second step, in the second stage, you have to write the criteria. What are the criteria? Style, reliability, and tourism. We have three criteria have been considered. Then, out of these are the options available. Of course, I have taken this example from the net. So these are foreign cars, not Indian cars. But you can write Indian cars over here. This is Civic, Saturn, Escort, Miata, in that range only. Range should be same. You cannot compare BMW with Maruti 800. The range should be same. Right? This is the scale. So this becomes the first comparison table, comparison matrix. Here what has been done? All the criteria have been compared among themselves, which is more important and which is less important. So how many comparison matrices will be there? A comparison will be there in the 3 by 3 matrix. Kitne comparisons honge isme? 9 cells honge, 3 comparisons honge, 3 reciprocal honge aur 3 diagonal honge. Theek hai? You will compare style versus reliability, style versus fuel economy, and reliability versus fuel economy. These 3 comparisons will be there. Theek hai? So you will compare and then write the value. Style versus reliability. Here reliability is more preferred. So reliability over style will have a weight of 2 and that will become 1 by 2. Similarly, style over fuel economy. Style is more preferred, so it is given a weight of 3. And fuel economy over style will become 1 by 3. Similarly, reliability over fuel economy given a weight of 4. And fuel economy over reliability will become 1 by 4. So that way you have to write and diagonal matrix will be 1 by 1, 1, 1. Then what you have to do? Here column sum. First we will take column sum. Then normalize the column sum. Each cell is divided by the column sum. Each cell is divided by the column sum. Then row average is taken over here. This becomes the priority vector. This is the priority vector for the this becomes the weights for the criteria. Of course, there are various methods for getting the priority vector. One method is you get the priority vector once, then you keep on multiplying this factor again and again, मतलब यू गेट स्केयर ऑफ दिस देन गेट द प्रायोरिटी वेक्टर देन स्केयर ऑफ स्केयर देन गेट द प्रायोरिटी वेक्टर वेयर द प्रायोरिटी वेक्टर स्टार्ट्स बिकमिंग कांस्टेंट दैट वैल्यू इज टेकन आइगन वैल्यू नॉर्मली here directly can be calculated, otherwise it can be calculated in that way also. Otherwise, there is one more method. In that method, what is there? You can get the here arithmetic mean is taken. You can get the geometric mean also. So there are various methods. So once this is obtained, the next step is to get the, these are the weights then. These 0.30, 0.60, 0.10 will become the weights. Now the next step is to get to see the consistency index. Normally what happens, there are three comparisons, you are preferring A over B, and if you are preferring B over C, the natural preference should be A should be preferred over C. Naturally the A should be preferred over C, but sometimes what happens, it is given otherwise. That is more इसमें ज्यादा चांसेस होता है इफ यू आर हैविंग फोर मोर देन फाइव फैक्टर्स बिकॉज इफ यू आर हैविंग फोर फैक्टर्स देन हाउ मेनी कंपैरिजंस विल बी देयर इफ यू आर हैविंग फोर फैक्टर्स या फोर अल्टरनेटिव्स हाउ मेनी कंपैरिजंस विल बी देयर इट इज बेसिकली एन इन टू एन माइनस वन बाई टू तो फोर के केस में कितने आ जाएंगे सिक्स सिक्स के कंपैरिजंस विल बी देयर सो When you make six comparisons, there is a chance that you will make a mistake of making the error. If there are five, then the comparisons will be 10. 10 may have a chance of mistake. So that mistake has to be identified through the consistency index. This has been explained. And the consistency ratio should be less than 0.1 for the matrix to be accepted. This has to be less than 0.1. So how we calculate it? This procedure is defined over here. The original matrix is multiplied by the priority vector A into X. Then we get the value of lambda X. Lambda X how we get? We divide AX by X. 0.90 by 3.30, 1.60 by 0.60, 0.35 by 0.10. This has been done over here. And the average of them. This becomes the lambda max. This becomes the lambda max. And this is the formula for the consistency index. Lambda max minus n divided by n minus 1. So that is how we get the consistency index. Then that consistency index is compared with this RI, a CR, consistency ratio. This is the standard table. In our case, the size of the matrix was 3, so the value will be 0.58. So this is the maximum level of consistency index that can be get, that we can get. And then CR is equal to CI, consistency index, divided by this RA, or CR, sorry. 0.03 divided by 0.58. So this should be less than 0.1. Then, after comparing the criteria among themselves to get the weight of the criteria, the next step is to compare the alternatives with respect to criteria, with respect to each of the criteria. So here, style, the early cars have been compared with respect to style, which is more preferred. As far as style is concerned, you have to compare Civic with Saturn, Civic with Escort, Civic with Miata, Saturn with Escort, Saturn with Miata and Escort with Miata. These are the six comparisons you have to make. So accordingly, the values have been entered in the cells. Right? Similarly, for the reliability and priority vector has been calculated. And you have to get the CI for the same also. Similarly, for reliability, you have to do the same thing for the reliability. Fuel economy, you can follow the same procedure, but here it has been done differently. Of course, you can do the same procedure, which is more preferred as far as fuel economy is concerned. Because fuel economy, for the fuel economy, direct values, direct mileage has been available, is available, so it has been used over here for the third director. So ultimately this will be the matrix will become this, like this. Here are the weights of the individual criteria, here are the weights of the star with respect to that very criteria. And then they have been multiplied in the matrix form. DS को basically ऐसे multiply करते हैं, 0.30 is multiplied with this, 0.60 is multiplied with this, 0.10 is multiplied with this, then summing up for the civic. उसको matrix form में भी multiply कर सकते हैं. So this way, now which car is more preferred? Near car. So this way you can calculate your preference. One more example is there, which I would like to show you. This is all. This I have taken from the Wikipedia only. Choosing the most suitable leader. On the basis of experience, education, charisma, and age. Four parameters are there. And we have three alternatives to only carry. So how the process is followed, you see here. First, Tom, Dick, Harry, their experience is defined. Their comparisons are made over here. If you compare Tom versus Dick, Tom and Dick with respect to their experience, which will you prefer more and why you prefer more? That statement has been made over here. So after the statement, it has been decided that Dick's experience is more than moderately preferred to Tom's, and weight is given 4. So the 4 is written over here. And 4 will come over here. Tom versus Dick come here. Tom versus Dick. Dick has a weight of 4. So this is done for all the 3 cases. And then priority vector has been calculated. And you have to calculate the consistency index also. This is versus for education. First we did for experience. Now we are doing for the education. Same thing. Same way it has been done, priority vectors have been calculated. Then for the charisma, then for the age. After that, what we need to do? We have to compare the criteria among themselves, which was done at first instance in case of earlier example, but here we are doing later on. So that can be done either way. You can do it first or later, that does not make any difference because it is an independent exercise. So, when you compare criteria, there will be how many comparisons? Because 4 criteria are there, so there will be 6 comparisons. So, 6 comparisons have been made here, pairwise comparisons have been made, and these have been translated into the matrix, and from the matrix, priority vector has been calculated. Consistency index has been calculated, and ultimately the problem will look like that. Here the calculations have been made. Their independent weights have been multiplied by the criteria weight. Then summing up. So which leader is preferred more in that case? Which leader is preferred more?
Bigs.
Hmm?
Bigs.
The second one. So this is how we apply the PHP. One more example I would like to show you. These are the examples, various examples. This is the example of to select the best supplier on the basis of 4 criteria. There are 4 suppliers, you can do it. There are 4 criteria and 4 alternatives, and the problem is to select the best supplier. The same way it has been done. It is the problem of validating the job offer. A person is getting a job offer from 4 companies, 4 or 3 companies, so how he can select the job. You see this example. How it is different from the earlier example? How it what is different from the earlier example? Can anyone let me know? If you look at the hierarchy.
Sub criteria
are also there. So how many comparison tables will be there in that case? How many comparison tables will be there?
Six.
How many comparison tables will be there? Can anybody tell me? So in this case, what we will do? We will compare all these six cars with respect to all these criteria. And first, what we do? First, we will compare the criteria among themselves. We get weight for cost, safety, style, and capacity. Then, what we will do? We will make another matrix for the subcomponents of the cost to compare themselves. Then, another matrix to compare the subcomponents of the capacity. So, three matrices will be there for the criteria comparison. Then we will have 6x6 matrices because there are 6 cars. 6x6 matrices for each of the sub-criteria and criteria. Where there is no sub-criteria for the criteria, we will use the criteria. And where there is a sub-criteria, we will use the sub-criteria. We will compare the 6 cars with respect to purchase price, fuel price, maintenance cost, resale value, safety, style, cargo capacity, and passenger capacity. Right? So this has been done. First, this is compared. The weights are there, both like that. The same way it has been done. Then, here, this matrix is compared. 4x4 matrix. These weights are obtained. These are the local weights. Here, 2x2 matrix is compared. These are compared. It's basically local matrix, local weights. Then, they are made global weights. Global weights कैसे बनेंगे? इनके सब क्राइटेरिया के वेट से क्राइटेरिया वेट से सब क्राइटेरिया वेट को मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे, राइट? देन वी विल कंपेयर ऑल दी सिक्स कार्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ऑल दीज. दैट हैज बीन डन. आई एम स्किपिंग दिस वन. लेट मी कमिंग टू द लास्ट स्लाइड. दिस problem will be this after comparisons. Here the weights are there. Global weights are there. Right? This has to be multiplied and then summing up. Is it fine?
Yes.
If you have any doubt, you can ask me right now. Then we come to the ENP. In ENP, what we do? I am not going into much detail of ENP, but let you know that ENP, I directly come to the example. For example, you see this example. This is the problem of a dam height selection. Dam height selection. So in that case, what we do? We have three criteria on the basis of dam height has to be selected. Now, what can we the criteria for dam construction or attributes for the dam construction? What can be the attributes for the dam construction? Kya kya ho sakte hain? It can be for the recreation, it can be for the flood control, it can be for the hydrology power condition. So what are the options available? It can be low height, it can be intermediate height, it can be high height. So these are three alternatives, these are three criteria. Now if you look at the EHP problem, there what we were doing, we were comparing the alternatives with respect to the criteria only. Now in that case, what we will be doing? We will be comparing the criteria with respect to alternative also. So how many comparison matrices will be there in that case? First, we will compare these three alternatives with respect to all these three criteria, three matrices. Then what we will do? We will compare the criteria with respect to each of the alternative. Three matrices will be there. So in all, there will be 6 matrices that you need to